You're watching BPD-TV.
Good afternoon. You're watching BPD-TV. I'm Detective Jeremy Silbert alongside Detective Donnie Moses, and this is your daily update for Labor Day, Monday, September 3rd, 2012. This past weekend, the international spotlight was on our city as we hosted the Grand Prix of Baltimore.
Officers were deployed throughout downtown to ensure that traffic was flowing and that all race spectators had a fun and safe time. The Baltimore Police Department worked very closely with our partners in the Baltimore City Fire Department, the Mayor's Office of Emergency Management, the Department of Transportation, and several other partners in our local, state, and federal law enforcement agencies.
Donnie, we both had the opportunity to be at the race this past weekend, and not only did we meet a lot of people from all over the country, but there were also some folks from other countries there?
Very true, Jeremy. There were.
Great event, and what an exciting finish to the Indy race yesterday afternoon. After a late race restart, Ryan Hunter Ray was able to hold off the other contenders and take the checkered flag. In other news, homicide detectives are investigating two murders that occurred over the past weekend. On Saturday morning, around 1:45 a.m., officers responded to a report of a shooting in the 1300 block of Lakewood Avenue. When officers arrived, they found a 22-year-old man suffering from a gunshot wound to his abdomen. The victim was transported to an area hospital where he later died from his injuries.
And on Sunday morning, at around 2:15 a.m., officers responded to the 4800 block of the Alameda for a report of a shooting. Officers located a 22-year-old woman with a gunshot wound to her chest. The victim was transported to Johns Hopkins Hospital, where she died a short time later. Homicide detectives are continuing to investigate both of these incidents and are asking that anyone with information to give them a call at 410-396-2100.
The Baltimore Police Department is continuing to mourn the death of Officer Forrest Taylor, who died last week.
A viewing will be held for Officer Taylor tomorrow, Tuesday, September 4th, beginning at 1 p.m. The funeral home is located at 1 2nd Avenue Southwest in Glen Burnie, Maryland.
And the funeral for Officer Taylor is scheduled for this Friday, September 7th, beginning at 10 a.m. The funeral will be held at the Cathedral of Mary Our Queen, located in the 5200 block of North Charles Street in Baltimore. Donnie, you had the opportunity to work with Officer Taylor?
Well, actually, Officer Forrest Taylor, we called him Dino, and I went to Police Academy together. One of the first things that I remember, or really that struck me, was the fact that he was a gentle giant. He was large in stature, but he was very soft in demeanor, very fair on the streets, very firm on the streets, and he carried a good reputation of being a good officer. And then lastly, the last time I talked to him, he spoke fondly of his child, which I believe is about a year old. From what I understand, he loved his family, he loved his kid, and he'll truly be missed.
And certainly our thoughts are with Officer Taylor's family this week. He was married with two young children. And finally, we want to wish everyone a happy and safe Labor Day.
While you're enjoying your extended holiday weekend, please remember that the Baltimore Police Department is fully staffed and our officers are out patrolling your neighborhoods to ensure that you and your families have a fun and safe holiday.
Remember to follow the Baltimore Police Department on Twitter, keyword Baltimore Police, for real-time news and updates. You can watch BPD-TV live Monday through Friday at 12:30 p.m. or watch past episodes of BPD-TV 24 hours a day by visiting our website at baltimorepolice.org.
You can also watch a rebroadcast of this program every night at 9 p.m. on Baltimore City's cable channel, TV 25. Thank you for watching BPD-TV. Enjoy your Labor Day.